on today's episode.
Legacy Hunter. We are the backbone of America. We are not afraid of getting our hands a little dirty. We work hard for what we have. We are where scripture takes action. We are average Joes. Your land and our land are the hunting grounds.
The Hunting Grounds is brought to you by Everett Chevrolet of Northwest Arkansas, Bedford Cameron Video, Morrell Targets, Hook, Line, and Sinker Outdoors, and by these fine sponsors.
The Hunting Grounds is blessed with a great team, family, and supporters and friends. We wanted to do something that got everybody together where we could know each other a little bit better. So we're going to get together at Wild World Paintball and shoot each other for a day. What more could you ask for?
I think this next game might be a little better because we know what we're doing now, so we'll see.
Again. Hey!
ladder, I promise. Where'd it hit me at? Where's it at?
I'm in here, I think.
Where am I hit at?
Hi, I'm Susie Everett with Everett Chevrolet, here with just one simple message. If you want a better way to buy a new Chevy, just come see us. You'll love the way we do business. Our customers have said it's the best car buying experience they've ever had. And we work hard to make sure every customer feels that same way. And so does Bo, although you might catch him taking a nap. Family owned, customer friendly, Everett Chevrolet in Springdale, I-540 at Elm Springs Road.
Hey guys! Hey guys!
View our videos at thg-tv.com. Follow us on Twitter at THGTV. Like us on Facebook as The Huntin' Grounds. Follow us on Instagram at THGTV.
When it comes to that shot of a lifetime,
and archery becomes more than an obsession,
and shooting is more than just a game.
Perfect practice. We'll make perfect shots.
Nobody beats Morrell.
Nobody.
We'll be right back.
He got out of range, did a snort wheeze just with my mouth. He turned on a dime. That pre-rut is going. He came all the way back down within 15 yards of me with the muzzleloader. Awesome hunt. Couldn't pass up that buck. Now I'm going for a big freak nasty monster, but that is not any bad 8-point in Northwest Arkansas. So we're gonna go check it out and see what he looks like. He's down. I saw him crash. He's just yards from my four-wheeler. So we'll go over there and take a look at him. Beautiful buck. The Ozarks here in Arkansas. Nice, nice buck. Thank you, Lord.
Well, you look at that. That is a well-deserved buck right there. Nice buck by any means up here in the Ozarks. Just definitely a cool hunt. Got to film it myself. There's nothing more rewarding than going out and filming yourself and then actually being successful at doing so for my first buck of the season. Nice, nice 8-point. We'll see what else we can get down.
Hi, I'm Susie Everett, inviting you to come see the all-new 2014 Chevy Silverado at Everett Chevrolet. The all-new Silverado delivers power, performance, and style. With a great new look, a new interior, and more industry-leading features. Take a test drive and discover the difference. The all-new 2014 Silverado. Check it out today at your family-owned, customer-friendly dealer. Everett Chevrolet in Springdale, I-540 at Elm Springs Road.
Okay, good luck, guys. Shoot straight. I've been a guide and an outfitter for most of my life. I developed a scientific product called Nose Jammer. It's not a scent eliminator or a chemical spray. Nose Jammer has concentrated levels of vanillin and other organic compounds found in the woods you hunt. The smell jams the olfactory gland in an animal's nose, so all he smells is his natural environment.
Vincent Productions, proud to be the post-production house of the Huntin' Grounds, providing audio, video, web, and design solutions in the Northwest Arkansas area and beyond. Visit us online at vincentprod.com. How do you save a life and find your best friend in one step? Adopt from your local animal shelter. Please donate food, bedding, or financial contribution to help their stay be a little bit better. Like us on Facebook for upcoming events and how you can help.
When it comes to that shot of a lifetime.
And archery becomes more than an obsession.
And shooting is more than just a game.
Perfect practice. We'll make perfect shots.
Nobody beats Morrell.
Nobody.
Nobody beats Morrell.
Well, we're in one of our Eagle Seed food plots that's been hit by the 1-2 punch of groundhogs and deer. If you look at the utilization cage here, we have almost 2 foot of growth at least. And if you look outside the utilization cage, it's been hammered by the groundhog. If you were to come in and look at this without this utilization cage, I would have no idea what these soybeans were supposed to be producing right now. Kind of looked at the food plot, could tell that it had some unusual browse, was able to pinpoint where the groundhog's den was, and you could tell that most of this browse is actually from a little bitty groundhog. The deer are in here consistently, but they aren't going to heavily pressure just one little area of this food plot. They're going to browse sporadically throughout the food plot where a groundhog is going to concentrate near his den area. Well, I'm in to save this food plot. I've come in, I've sprayed the weeds to eliminate that competition. I put a little bit of fertilizer down. Now I've got the plot saver barrier system I want to put up around this food plot. It's going to keep the deer out and allow these soybeans to grow up 2 to 3 feet. Then I'm going to let the deer back in here where it's going to be able to stand the browse pressure from the deer. Hopefully at the same time, it'll keep the groundhog out, but I'm going to be sitting in the blind trying to take him out as well. Now this plot saver barrier system works against the deer's senses. It's got a repellent that's in the ribbon that we've soaked in beforehand. Now they suggest that you spray it, but if you have the opportunity, I go ahead and I soak it before I put it out, just pre-treating it. But basically, it just keeps the deer out of the area. Now if you were to spray this on the foliage, it'd keep the deer from eating it, but that's not what we want to teach them. We simply want to keep them out of this area until it's allowed to grow up a little bit more where it can keep up with the pressure that the deer are going to put on it. So what they suggest when you're putting up the ribbon for white-tailed deer is put about 30 inches up on your post. Now I could have gone and purchased a green T-post, but instead I went and purchased this white post here. It was about half the cost. It's actually got slits for the ribbon to already go in. An importance of using a visual aid as well as a sense of smell for the deer. Anything white's really visual for them, so I went ahead and made sure for the plot barrier system that I got the white ribbon and I've got the white post. So it's going to be a visual aid as well as working with your sense of smell. Now you can see the post in the back. You want your post to be about 30 feet apart throughout your entire food plot. With the starter kit that I got, you can get about 850 feet of that ribbon that will do about an acre of a food plot. We've got our plot saver system set up, ready to go. We went ahead and pre-treated the ribbon that's around it. Aren't going to have to come back in for another 30 days. At that time, our soybeans might be tall enough that we're taking down the barrier system, allowing the deer to get in to browse. We'll just have to take a look at that. For about every 30 days, you want to retreat it. If you're going to leave it up for longer than that, we'll see how this works.
One that was still I can't even talk. I've been needing to clear my throat for 30 minutes. I've been trying not to make a noise, but got me a coyote. There's a bunch of them. Saw a little bitty spike buck chasing some does and couldn't decide if I wanted to shoot him or not. Oh, and this is also my first time filming my own hunt, so I wanted to make something happen. Thank you, Lord. I know he's not a monster, but I'm sure happy with him. And that's what counts, right? But here he is. This morning decided to go ahead and shoot him. I'm not sure if he's the same guy or not, but I'm proud of him. He ain't bad.
The Huntin' Grounds is brought to you by Everett Chevrolet of Northwest Arkansas, Bedford Cameron Video, Morrell Targets, Hook, Line, and Sinker Outdoors, and by these fine sponsors.
Here, tell me.
I'm hurting. Right here.
You're walking.
It's that guy right there.
Yeah. Three shots of the ribs.
Swap.
And the
come
face.
Come back from revenge, Steven.
And the face hit.
I got shot.
Yeah, it's pretty hot, but we're having fun. Been having a lot of luck getting shot anyway.
Up the day here at Wild World. Got a bunch of friends, family, and the staff out here. Had a great time, a lot of bruises, a lot of bumps and a bunch of scrapes, but that's what we were here for. Had a blessed time just hanging out with our family and friends. Can't wait to do it next time here at Wild World. Whether you're going through the struggles of filming a hunt or through the pain of getting hit with high velocity projectiles, you can always count on your friends and family to be there. Until next time, enjoy creation and continue your traditions and be a legacy hunter. And as always, have a better than average day.
Music provided by Back Road Anthem and by Brian Matthew Ellis.
It wasn't too bad other than I couldn't get my barrel plug on, so they kept firing 90 rounds at me.
Shut up, mister.
means.
Hey, Steve, come look at this.
Oh, hey.
Ow,
did that hurt?
Yeah.
I got hit in the arm, but it didn't bust.
And what did, like, oh, God, fuck.
God.
What?
You got, like, spit.
I know, I tried to spit, I forgot there's a mouth guard.
The game plan paid off. We got guys swarming around the sides, went to the front of the building. We owned that round. I think the last of our survivors are coming out, so redemption just took place.